You may be seated. Thank you so much. Okay, so welcome. My name is Dean Williams. I'm the senior sponsor of the DeKalb School of the Arts class of 2022. Will you please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance and the National Anthem? I will lead you in the Pledge of Allegiance. I think the flag comes up on the screen. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please remain standing. Miles Anthony Johnson will perform the national anthem along with Jordan Gomez, Tabitha Gordon, Thomas Jones, and Rehan Mamman. Okay, so that's how we do it here. You can have a seat. Thank you so much. Graduation here at DeKalb School of the Arts is not only just a ceremony, it's also our last performance. So my dancers, you need to be getting ready. Dancers, go ahead and head back to the room to get ready. And for right now, we have the band and orchestra seniors. You can sit on both sides. You can do whatever you want. We're gonna have a dance party soon. Miss Madden's gonna lead it. Mr. Moore, our orchestra and band teacher, who cannot be here today because he has his own son graduating today, put these two songs together, would arrange this music for the band and orchestra students. Enjoy. Thank you. Okay. Thank you, band and orchestra. We are the champions. Yes. And now for our salutatory and a speech, Miss Taylor West.
Nice and loud, Taylor. Okay, good afternoon, everyone. So my name is Taylor West, and it was such an honor to be selected as salutatorian for the DSA class of 2022. There were so many other people who really put so much into their studies, and they deserved it just as much as I did. But so first of all, I want to say congratulations to everyone who's here today about to walk across this stage. You've all worked really hard to get to this point. At times, it's definitely felt like we've been swimming against the current. We started off this year by coming in for in-person classes for the first time in a year and a half, with no math teachers, in a building that was doing its best to fall apart around us. But no matter the challenge, you guys have pushed through. You've managed to keep up with all your classes, be members and leaders of clubs and community organizations, and put on some pretty amazing productions. I also want to give a really big thank you to all the teachers that have helped us along the way. We really couldn't have made it this far without your hard work in keeping our education on track through every difficulty and interruption. I especially want to thank Dr. Hunt, who's worked for me for the past 5 years on improving my writing. The fact that I've managed to write anything good and win competitions is only because of the many truly awful pieces she had to grade before them. And I also want to thank Magister Ruff, who put up with me for 4 years, and who made translating even Caesar's 5 pages of technical warfare terms fun. I never did get to summon that demon, but you made sure there was no lack of chanting and ritual sacrifices in your classroom, and I enjoyed every second of it. Thank you to all of the social studies teachers who worked so hard to make sure I did well on their AP exams, and who always stopped me when I'm walking through the halls just to say hello. And thank you to all of the teachers who had to leave before us, but did an absolutely wonderful job while they were here. Thank you also to Principal Green and all the administrators who've held this school together, to Ms. Howard, who excused all of my many sick days, and to Ms. Staples, who me and my parents harassed many times about my schedules and online classes, and who always did her best to help us. And for everyone else here, all the parents, friends, and family, thank you for being here. You've supported us every step of the way, and we never would have made it this far without you. To my own parents, thank you for helping me with my homework, especially that horrific AP physics homework, for putting up with me for when I was exhausted from sleeping 6 hours a night for months on end, and for fighting for me every step of the way. I'm also really grateful for all the people I've met here. So many of you are not only talented and hardworking, but also really kind. I've never felt like an outsider here. Before coming here, I bounced around a few different schools and magnet programs, but I knew this was the place I wanted to be when I got here, and I heard the rumors about how many people were willing to randomly give you a hug in the hallways. Some of you I will have the honor of going off to college with, and some of you are not going to be able to escape me. You know who you are, and if you don't text me back, I will be getting on an 8-hour plane ride to see you. For those of you who I might never see again, I might not know the path that you're going to take, but I do know that you're going to take it far. As the inspirational quote site I Googled while writing this tells me, DSA alumna Stacey Abrams once said, "When we show up, act boldly, and practice the best ways to be wrong, we fail forward. No matter where we end up, we've grown from where we began." So I hope that no matter where you go, no matter what you do, you're failing forward. And I also think that Ms. Abrams would really like me to remind you to go vote in the primary next Tuesday. Thank you, and good luck.
Thank you, Taylor. My 4 drama people can come up and get ready. Right now we have some dance for you. The dance majors have put together, and there's a bunch of them. I didn't realize. There's a lot. Okay. This is the dance majors with a piece they called Liberation.
I got a feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. A feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. A feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. A feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. Tonight's the night. Let's live it up. I got my money. Let's spin it up. Go out and smash it. Like, oh my God. Jump out that sofa. Let's kick it off. Fill up my cup, mazel tov. Look at her dancing, just take it off. Let's paint the town, we'll shut it down. Let's burn the roof,
and then we'll do it again.
Let's do it, let's do it, let's do it, let's do it. And do it, and do it,
let's live it up.
And do it, and do it, and do it, do it, do it. Let's do it, let's do it, let's do it. I got a feeling, ooh, that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. A feeling, ooh, that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night.
Mary Catherine, Mary Catherine, can you get ready in 4 minutes? I got you. All right. Are you excited? Did you dance too? I hope you did. The four of our drama majors have a little story about the last 5 years here at DSA, and they're going to talk about it. Thank you. You guys get up to that mic and speak loud.
If you had asked us what we thought our experience in the DSA drama department would be like, well,
living out victorious in real life,
bettering our acting skills,
feeling the rush of numerous opportunities.
And that happened.
Sure it did.
There were some things we didn't expect.
And those became defining moments of our high school careers.
Let's do it in the best way we know how. Kunja?
Kunja. 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 Kunja.
Good morning, Mr. Wright.
Good morning, students. We're going to talk about Stanislavski today. Sit down, relax, and we'll get started.
All right. Yeah. Where are you sitting? If you sit like that, you're giving all your energy to the floor. You won't have any energy to perform. Stand up. Anyways, it's tech week for Dark Knight, and Dr. Hunt wants us to build a boat. Do we have the means to build a boat? No. Do we have the time to build a boat? No. This is what happens when people who don't understand how the theater works try to produce shows. But I'll do it anyways.
Mongo, we can't find the ladder.
Mongo, why is your name Mongo?
Mongo, we have to send out the current production credits.
And we need to start planning for Nutcracker.
What's the new musical?
Parents are concerned about crewing for shows. How long are the rehearsals again?
Mongo!
All right. Yeah. You're in charge of class for today.
Oh, okay. I guess we'll start with a warm-up. I need all of your cameras on, well-lit. I need to see your whole bodies, and no bonnets or messy rooms either. Okay, stand up. We're going to do some yoga. You're a tree. Now you're a bush. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Excuse me, Zarya? Is that a cat crawling around in your desk? No, no, no. This is a serious class and you will not disrespect it.
Does anyone know where Dr. MB went?
I'll check Google Classroom. It says she'll be gone for a week.
She was not gone for just a week. She was gone for the rest of the semester.
She dipped, man.
Didn't even get a goodbye.
Is this what it means to be ghosted?
She most certainly ghosted us.
Well, I'm sleeping in for real now, I'll tell you that much.
Yeah, it's not like this is our major and we're supposed to be learning useful technique and performing, but...
Blame it on COVID. All right, class, play reports are due tonight on Turnitin. You must see a play. If I find that you plagiarized or you're using a play from one of your classes, you're getting a zero, no exceptions.
Are we allowed to do musicals?
Musicals? Musicals are not acting. That is dancing and singing. Save it for your dance critiques. Now, who's running warm-ups today?
I am.
Great. Your Udahagen 9-question assignments, as well as your B scores, are due tonight. You must turn in order to perform for your final grade. Are there any questions?
No.
Good. And turn on that fan. It's like a sauna in this black box.
Is there a reason the black box feels like taking a hike through hell?
Is there a reason we've had 6 different drama teachers over the course of 4 years?
Is there a reason none of us are in drama ensemble, even though we're all drama majors? Let's call it the DSA method.
Hey, at least we're actually learning something in this class.
Guys, stop arguing. Come on. Who saw? Who saw?
The act of calming down when you want to get up. Why is our drama class so corrupt? Who saw? Who saw? Come on, guys. Don't you want to do your spoken word? Come on.
Who-sa, who-sa. The act of calming down when you want to get up. Why is our drama class so corrupt?
We do everything but act in most of these classes, yet we still captivate the masses.
These conditions are at times unjustifiable, but know that our talent is undeniable.
Who-sa, who-sa.
So that was our DSA drama experience.
It wasn't what we expected,
but maybe that's what made it worth more.
So now we end in the best way we know how.
Na 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 na. This is how we go. Places!
Thank you, Places!
That was it. That was a lot. In 4 or 5 years. And now she's back from dancing and she's all, well, she's got everything, she's all together. Okay. Mary Catherine Abound, our valedictorian, will now address you all. Let's give her a hand.
Good afternoon, DSA graduates, family, and friends. First of all, congratulations to everyone on this remarkable achievement. Despite 2 years in a worldwide pandemic and 5 years in a building held together by a plastic water bottle, we managed to stand here today, evidence of our dedication and the resilience of the community we have built together. While I am honored to be named valedictorian and I worked hard to get here, this is not how I define myself or my high school experience. I would like to use this opportunity and my voice to remind each of you that you are not a number. We are not our GPA or our SAT score or our class rank. I know the college application process can make us believe otherwise, but we are more than data on a page. You are a whole person with a unique, valuable, and creative perspective that you bring to every experience and relationship in your life. I have been lucky to grow up with many impressive role models. Both of my parents were valedictorians and have made tremendous accomplishments in their respective fields. They taught me to love learning, and I so appreciate their unconditional love and support. But the people in my life who have truly taught me the value of perseverance, determination, and intellectual curiosity independent of a grade are people in my life whose intelligence goes largely unrecognized. As many of you know, both of my brothers have autism, and they struggled long and hard to piece together an education in a system determined to overlook them and hold them back. I am continuously inspired by their never-ending grit and eternal spirit. They are the role models who taught me to value learning, curiosity, and individuality over any one-size-fits-all standard. They are the reason I will never underestimate another person's intelligence and the reason I will always presume competence. My high school career was so much more than a culminating GPA. It was friends and performances, fun and stress, laughing and crying and dancing and singing. It was learning for the sake of knowledge and not simply to pass a test. It was the Walmart trips and boba runs and show weekends I shared with so many of you. You are not numbers to me, and I hope I am not just a valedictorian to you. I hope you see me as a friend, a peer, and just one pillar in the support system we have built together over the last 5 years. You are my high school experience, and I could not be prouder of my DSA family. I will never forget you, and I will never fight on a Thursday. Congratulations. Thank you.
Issue. I'm not crying. A little bit. Our creative writers have a tradition every Wednesday called Workshop Wednesday, and they're going to speak about that. And here's the majors, creative writing majors.
It's your favorite day of the week, Workshop Wednesday, your last one. Don't whine. It's easy, I promise. Your prompt is the last 5 years of creative writing.
Eighth grade, a whirlwind of excitement and unfiltered words. Characters that will always have a special place in your heart.
The beginning of our journeys, it's all begun to blur. Our stories may have been rough, but that was just the start.
Ninth grade, we bring stories to life with color and learn how to make words sing. Haikus, senryus, tankas, and others, what chronicles will we bring?
We wrote short stories galore, crafting mystery, characterization, flash fiction. We grew and learned so much more. We started to hone our skills in diction.
10th grade, seeing our characters on stage, in motion, taking flight, when our creative afternoons cultivated our dark night.
A murder is arranged, our own TV shows. We made endless plays, formed the cause of our woes.
11th grade, the year that didn't exist, writing scripts from our bedrooms, alone with our characters.
And while giving up was easy, we managed to resist. And we pushed through NaNoWriMo and then became screenwriters.
12th grade is spent crafting our portfolio, writing pieces until we reached 13. Will we meet deadlines? No one knows, but after this, we'll all be free.
It's a bittersweet ending, saying goodbye to everyone. But the future's no longer pending. It's here. We're finally done.
3, 2, 1!
Time's up! Fingers off keyboards!
All right. They're coming on stage. The piece Optimistic that we're going to hear was arranged by Zuri Crawford, our senior, one of our seniors. And as soon as they get up there, you can mash play.
video that I sent him that he's in the thing that being played during this.
Okay, so that's the entertainment portion of our show, and now we're getting down to the real business of why we're here. To make some principal's remarks, our outgoing principal, we're sad to see him go. I love you, Mr. Green. is going to remarks, and then we will go on with the official conferring and validating the diplomas. Thank you.
Good evening, parents, friends, and most importantly, the DSA class of 2022. On behalf of the faculty, the staff, and the administration of the class of 2022 from a Georgia top 10 school, the number one school in DeKalb County, and the number one school in all of our hearts, the DeKalb School of the Arts, I am pleased to present the academic summary of the class of 2022. This class consists of 76 graduates and has accomplished the following academically. 25 of the 76 have a GPA of 4.0 or higher. A whopping 83% of this class is eligible for the Hope Scholarship. 100% of students will attend a four-year college or university. As of last count, over $1 million in scholarship offers have been granted to this class. And we must recognize Zaria Franklin for receiving $269,000 of scholarship offers. And Caroline Riley with $281,000 of scholarship offers. This class will attend our fine Georgia institutions, UGA, Georgia Tech, GSU, State and Southern, Kennesaw State, Georgia College, and so many more, including the University of North Carolina, Emory University, Sarah Lawrence College, Loyola Marymount, USC, Florida State, Worcester, SCAD, Case Western Reserve, Northeastern and Northwestern, and our fine historically black colleges and universities, Spelman College, Savannah State, Tennessee State, FAMU, Claflin, Grambling, North Carolina A&T, Dr. Tinsley, Clark Atlanta, and of course, HU. At this time, please join me in welcoming our interim superintendent, Dr. Vassan Tinsley, our chief educational officer of DeKalb County School District, to the podium to certify the academic summary of this class of 2022.
Wow. The class of 2022 for DeKalb School of the Arts. You guys look wonderful. Let's give them a hand. We're very, very proud of you. Graduates, today is your day. You did more than just show up to class every day. You went the extra mile, you pressed through, and you succeeded during what may have been some of the most challenging times in your lifetime. You did more than just earn a diploma. You believed, you excelled, you dreamed, you never gave up, and you soared to new heights. Former First Lady Michelle Obama once said, empower yourselves with a good education, then get out there and use that education to build a country worthy of your boundless promise. I have no doubt that this class will do just that. Class of 2022, DeKalb School of the Arts, please know that the DeKalb County School District is extremely proud of you. And we look forward to hearing about all of your accomplishments. Congratulations, continue to inspire, achieve, and excel. And remember, always lift as you climb. Now, as the interim superintendent of the DeKalb County School District, I present the class of 2022 for DeKalb School of the Arts. I certify that these students have met all course requirements and have earned, at minimum, 24 Carnegie units as established by Cognia, the State Board of Education, the Georgia Accrediting Commission, and the DeKalb Board of Education. Therefore, I am requesting that our board member, Mrs. Deirdre Pierce, release their diplomas. Let's welcome Mrs. Pierce.
Well, good evening, everyone. It is absolutely a joy to be here to celebrate this wonderful occasion with you. And Mr. Green, Principal Green, Dr. Tinsley, on the basis of your certification, I accept your recommendation. The academic achievement of this class meets the course requirements as established by Cognia, the Georgia Board of Education, the Georgia Accrediting Commission, and the DeKalb County Board of Education. As a representative of the DeKalb County Board of Education, it gives me great pride and great pleasure to authorize the release and presentation of diplomas and certificates to the 2022 class of talented scholars at DeKalb School of the Arts. Congratulations to everyone. I'm gonna take a real quick moment to point of pleasure and privilege, if I may, to speak to the choral majors. You made it a little difficult for Mrs. Pierce to stay professional sitting over in her seat when you all were singing. It was wonderful, and that's one of my favorite songs. Thank you.
We would have loved it if you got up and danced, right? All right. We are ready for the moment. Come on up, seniors. Row two, be ready. I present the graduates of 2022. Mary Catherine S. Abaud, valedictorian. Taylor S. West, salutatorian. Maria Y. Bonta, top 10. Talia Ford, top 10. Zaria E. Franklin, top 10. Tabitha K. Gordon, top 10. Audrey P. Howell, top 10. Thomas C. Jones III, top 10. Nefertari P. Joseph, top 10. Hannah F. Watlington, top 10. And other graduates to follow. Clara E. Adams. Shiraz Augustine. Abisola Ali. Ella R. Anderson. Joy C. Ani. Adeyemi Atobra. Jaden D. Barkley. Aiden K. Barry. Lola A. Beal. No, Yendi? Yendi. I'm sorry, no. Emma Belmonte. Yendi Bay. Violet P. Bishop. Jada G. Bogues. What? Bogues. That's Bogues. that says Bouges. Dana Boyer. Was that O? Grace O. Britton. Nisa A. Broughton. Monet Comorto Williams. Chloe A. Carroll. Brooklyn S. Castleberry. Maurice Claremont Jr.
Is that a D?
Trinity D. Colbert. Devin Craig. Zuri A.G. Crawford. Jada Davis. Jada S. Epps. Miles Ford. Spa, but a white boa winner. He gets to wear that. That's not just a thing. Jordan T. Gomez. Ariana Goodwin. Taylor Harris. Azaria B. Hightower. Tatum J. Hill. Jeanette L. Hillary. Leonardo A. Hinnett. Thomas Hollihan. Karma S. Hundahl. Charles R. Johnson. Miles Anthony Johnson. Sydney N. Johnson. Abigail C. Kirk. Amos L. Ligenfelter. Maya Lott. Leanna Maddox. Rehan Mamin. Jack E. Marino. Maxine Moss. C. L. Audrey L. Mothershed. Sydney E. Mullins. Sydney A. Norman. Walker O'Brien. Ryan Odom. Kanan A. Parikh. Kanan. Nyla M. Pendleton. Miles A. Pope. Ilana Purefoy. Miranda D. Rhodes. Caroline J. Riley. Nathaniel P. Roberts. Zoe M. Sampson. Skylar J. Sanford. Phoebe M. Surser. Zari Shabazz. Dahlia C. Shepherd. Megan P. Shepherd. Tiosha C. Shepherd. Yatoria L. Thrasher. Nyree K. Wright.
I need another card. Remind me. I need to get a card for my thing.
Can I please have Joy and Miranda come back up on stage? Joy and Miranda. Seniors, you can get your bubbles that you have under your chair. Joy Ani and Miranda Rhodes. Okay, good. Our visual artist, our visual arts instructor, Miss Jacobs, decided last year that she wanted to try this thing called the bubble ceremony. So we did it last year and it was so beautiful that I thought we could continue to do it. And so while we're gonna give a little background from Joy and Miranda. And then you'll see some of the work of the visual artists on the screen.
Hello, everybody.
My name is Miranda Rhodes.
And my name is Joy Ani, and we're both visual arts seniors.
I've been at DSA for 5 years.
And I've been there for 3.
And we've both had the unique opportunity to experience DSA.
DSA has become more than just a building, and it may be full of open ceilings, spiderwebs, and the odd squirrel or two, but it has also become a home where bonds with wonderful people have grown into something beautiful through our love of the arts.
Students here are like a light, each one with talent and creativity as bright as the sun. This makes DSA a prism. When they're put together, a rainbow appears.
As you blow these bubbles, remember this fact.
And don't ever stop being leaders.
Trailblazers.
And creators. You should all be proud of who you are.
And what you will accomplish, no matter where you are in the future.
Congrats, class of 2022.
Congrats.
To the class of 2022.
Keep going, keep going. He's so nervous.
Continue to blow those bubbles while we enjoy the visual on the board. Is it on the board? Are we seeing visual artists? Are we seeing visual artists on the big screen? With some fun music. Thank you. Another tradition is turning of the tassel, so prepare yourself, seniors. Dr. Riley will be performing the turning of the tassel.
Now it's time for the turning of the tassel ceremony. Now this act traditionally represents the transition from candidate to graduate, but the symbolism of this act is much, much more profound. It represents the culmination of a myriad of events and decisions which has brought you to this very point in your life today. Now, many of these events have been shared today on the stage and throughout your 4 or 5 years and in front of the people here today. But it also represents the beginning of a chapter in your life where you are about to embark upon a journey where new memories will be formed. Now, what will make these memories different is that they will be created with people you have yet to meet. So before we go through the motion of turning your tassel, I would like for you to take a deep pause. Close your eyes, if you will, and consider the following. Picture yourself thumbing through the pages of a book of your life. From the time that you were born, through elementary school, middle school, and even today. You periodically pause at the various pages and reminisce over particular momentous events and the individuals who made a meaningful impact. Now, at each reflected moment, you are leaving and you are left with the urge to forge forward through the good times, through the bad times. You forge forward. Now you eventually reach the chapter where the story is yet to be written. The only words on the page are, make me memorable, make me meaningful, but most importantly, make me yours. Now open your eyes or come back here today. Receive the moment and know that you have yet a story of accomplishments. And as you move the tassel to the next chapter, just know that the next chapter has begun. Graduates of the class of 2022, please stand up. Woohoo! Now face your family and friends. At this time, move your tassel from the right to the left. Now continue your story by making it a book that's worth reading. Again, congratulations, class of 2022. You may be seated.
All right. One last thing is the alma mater. So will everyone please stand? We have Monet, Mary Catherine, Maurice, and Jaden, and a balloon flying over the fields. That's memorable, isn't it? They're gonna sing the alma mater once. It's in your program. I hope you got one. I made 600 of them. They're going to sing it once, and then you're going to sing with again the second time. And watch Mr. Duncan. He will conduct you. All right. Please stand and sing heartily the second time through.
Crowd, we will sing with voice. DSA stands proud. Ever moving, moving onward, never looking back. Hail to thee, our alma mater. Hail to DSA. DSA stands proud. Ever moving, moving onward, never looking back. Hail to thee, our alma mater. Hail to DSA.
Thank you very much. We will recess out. The stage will go first, and everyone please remain standing, and then Maria will start with you. Yes, Maria Bonta, when the time comes. Thank you so much. Class of 2022, well done. Well done. All this and you did it. Parents and everyone, you can meet your senior. They'll come up to you. Thank you, Dr. Tinsley. And make sure you check around and make sure you have all of your things. Make sure you have all of your things. Wait until they come by. I will tell you when to go, Maria. Thank you, America. Don't lose your hat. Stay in line. Stay in line, please. Please stay in your chairs. I know you're excited. See these people right here, Maria? You're going to follow them. And then who's that behind you? Who's directly behind you? No, behind you. Tell her she's, yeah. First row, here we go. Follow Mary Catherine and Taylor. Thank you. Move. Okay, go, next row. Monet, yes. Jaden, go ahead, just get in line, it doesn't matter. They're like kindergartners. Go, thank you. Audrey Mothershed, you're next line, you're the next line, thank you.